We are pleased to welcome you to the Edisla Guide. There is nothing more fascinating than stargazing. Edisla's three-point guide will give you a clear idea of what to look for in a telescope. Number 1. Aperture size. It is the diameter of the primary lens or mirror. Generally, larger telescopes offer better images, cost more, and are heavier. For optimal use, we recommend a size between 4.5 and 8 inches. In contrast to binoculars, telescopes allow the user to adjust magnification with the use of different eyepieces. Likewise, if someone tries to sell you a telescope by stating X value, beware. Number 2. Types. If you have ever had any interest in telescopes, you may have heard the words reflector and refractor. A reflector reflects light beams between mirrors within a telescope tube and into the eyepiece. It costs less to produce these telescopes. Yet they produce high-quality images and offer excellent magnification. For beginners with modest budgets, a 4.5 reflector telescope is an excellent choice. There is a problem with the reflectors. The mirrors inside need adjusting from time to time and cleaning since they collect dust. Due to the position of the eyepiece at the top of the tube, they are not suitable for children. A refractor deflects or refracts light. There are no mirrors, just lenses. At the top of the tube, there is a lens through which light enters, which leads to the eyepiece at the bottom. In contrast to reflectors, refractors have very high-quality images, a solid design, virtually no maintenance, and an eyepiece located at the bottom, making it accessible to children. They are, however, the most expensive telescopes. Price increases with telescope size. A third type uses both mirrors and lenses and is called a catadioptric or compound telescope. They are another topic for discussion. Number 3. Mount. A telescope's mount plays an instrumental role in seeing a sharp image. First and foremost, the tube must remain steady. Secondly, the tube must move with the object so that it does not disappear from view. A mount is necessary in order to accomplish this. The alt-az mount is the most basic type. You can move the tube up, down, right, and left to keep up with your star. It is an inexpensive and durable type of mount. A Dobsonian mount replaces tripods with a pan-tilt head mounted to the ground. Typically, Dobsonian mounts are made of wood or particle board, resulting in a low-cost, highly effective mount. Installing Newtonian reflectors in this way is not only easy, but also cheap. Equatorial azimuth mounts rotate in the same plane as the equator instead of the ground like alt-az mounts. In this way, celestial objects appear to move as the Earth spins. Finally, all these mounts can be motorized or automated, resulting in GODUs or other computer-guided mounts. Edisla hopes you have learned a few telescope basics. No matter where you live or who you are, there is a telescope for you. It's never too late to share the wonders of the universe. Have a great time stargazing.